Hello my dear friends, today in this video I will discuss about two important parameters, that is impact factor and second is the H index, right? So all this comes into the research matrix, but today we don't know about that these parameters matrix of a research publications related to the journals or related to the article. So let us decide it after watching this video, and this video will be useful to those who are basically in early phase of the research career and doing the research and publication ethics course, which is basically designed by the UGC for all the researchers. Right, and it is of 2 credit course. So I am just defining here one of the part of that, but I have some questions here. So the question is that how to search good journals in a specific subject or in a multidisciplinary subject, right? So this is the first question, and second question that comes in my mind, does high impact factor of the journal motivates you to submit the article in those journals? What do you think? If you see any high impact journal, do you think always you have to submit the article into that particular journal of your subject? And similar question, if you see the high impact journal, then what do you think? You have to read the articles only of that journal, or only on that particular journal which basically belongs to your subject? Fourth question, how basically the librarian decide the list of the journals, right, for a specific subject, right? For in case of physics, they are interested, suppose, to collect the good journals. So how basically they will subscribe the journal for the library, right? This is the fourth question that came in my mind. And fifth question is, do you really think that all the funding agencies looks the impact factor of the published article for the grantee, right? Or this is a criteria that if you had published the good research article with the good impact factor journals, so research grants, taking the research grants become so easy? And very important question that I think nowadays the institution basically give the importance to the individual, either to the individual or you can say to the department or school, those who basically publish the articles or score the high impact factor score, right? So do your institution basically involved in this kind of practice? It may be related to the incentives, or it may be related to the the special grants to the school, to the department. If the faculty members of that particular school, a particular department are publishing good articles in good journals, whether they are getting or not getting the citation from that particular journal in your in their research. And here one more question actually, do you think that impact factor is associated with the citation of the published research article only of that journal for which it is calculated? The question directly related to the how the impact factor basically this Clarivate Analytics calculate, which is a sister company of the Web of Science. And I think this is the last question, and in this question you can get an idea that do we really need to analyze the impact of the individual department's research by the impact factor only, or is there any other criteria by which we can say that this is the impact of this particular faculty member or department into that specific domain? So these were some questions, and I want to find out the answer of these questions through the analysis of this impact factor parameter. Does the impact factor provide all these information, or we face a kind of problem that where the approach of the impact factor basically get limited? So let us see about to it what basically is impact factor. So according to the Clarivate analytics, how they define this impact factor. So they define it is a measure of the frequency with which the average article in a journal has been cited in a particular year or period, right? So we can find out that analysis, and you people are aware that you can get all the information about to the site about to the impact factor of any journal through the journal citation report. So I'm just taking an example of the year 2020. So here, first of all, if you need to calculate the impact factor, so how basically those people calculate the impact factor, the formula which is given at different places in the similar way. So first of all, we count the citations that we had received from the past 2 years. Like if suppose I am interested to calculate the impact factor for the year 2020, then I need citation of the past 2 years, like 2018 and 19, from the article which published in that journal. And second parameter is that I have to find out the total number of the articles that published into the past 2 years. So as per the formula, impact factor will be ratio of the A and B. So that will be the impact factor of the 2020. So this is the way. If you had to find out the impact factor in 2021, so you will require the year 20 and 19. So for that particular journal, suppose you are, there is a XYZ name of the journal, and you want to calculate the impact factor, or you want to know the impact factor. So what is the criteria for the calculation? They choose the past 2 years, right? Past 2 years, suppose we are calculating impact factor for the 2020. So the past 2 year will be 2018 and 19. So how much citations actually they got from the articles which published into the 2018 and 19. So let us make it clear by some calculation. Here in 2018, actually, the article which published into the 2018, we got the citation in the year 2020 were 85. And the article which get published into the year 2019, we got citation from that only 65. So it happens generally, right? Because oldest paper get more citation as compared to the newest one. So here total citation in the year 2020, we got only 150, right? So this is the way to get the citation. And B is the total number of article published in the year 2018, the total 48 article published, and in 2019, 55 article published. So overall 103 article published. So here you can see A and B. So total citation we got in the year 2020 were 150, and the total articles were 103. So citation of the year 2020 will be 150 divided by 103. So the impact factor will be 1.45. Now we have seen here about to the impact factor. So let us discuss about some facts related to the impact factor, and we will analyze those facts here. So first of all, here you can see the date of publication, right? As you know that to calculate the impact factor, we required only the past 2 years, right? You may have seen also the impact factor for the 5 years of the published research article. So here I want to point out one more thing, that if the article basically published 7 years before or 10 years before, so why and is still getting citations, right? Right, you got my point? The article which was published into 7 years before into this journal in 2013 or 2012. Is still getting the citation, but citations are not a part of this impact factor calculation. So there is no contribution of those articles which basically is still getting the citations for that journal. So here in this calculation of the impact factor, only the 2 years are involved. So my point and the thing basically which we noted here, that if suppose an article published into the 2013, that how you will basically getting the contribution of that article? Is that article is not contributing to the author? Is that article is not contributing to the journal? If you see the article which get published into this journal in 2012, is still getting citation, so that citation comes into the picture or picture, right, into the author's profile, right? And that citation basically you can analyze in terms of the when you calculate the H index. So what the benefit H index had taken from here, the article which were getting the citation right before the calculation of the impact factor, or the years where impact factors are not involved, so there basically H index had taken the benefit of that, you can say. So similarly, now the point is, if that article which was published into the 2013 and 12 in this particular journal directly don't contribute to the impact factor of the journal, but on the other hand it comes into the credit of the author, and author basically from here see a new parameter that is called H index, right? Into that in the calculation of H index, that citation basically comes into the picture. So the missing point of the impact factor basically comes into the picture of the H index. You got my point? If you are aware about to the H index calculation, then it might be clear to you whatever I am saying or convey to about to it, right? So here this was a drawback, and its drawback basically get the benefit by the get its benefit by the H index. And second point here, article value. So when you see the impact factor of the journal, actually you cannot decide the quality of the each and individual article, right? And you may also see seen all these things, that if you see high impact factor journal or good journal, so in the good journals you may have seen it is very frequent that not all the articles which basically get published into that journal not getting equal citation, or sometimes it happened that many article even don't get a single citation into the last 2 years, 3 years, right? So there are many articles which don't get even a single citation into the journal. So impact factor just tell us about only the journal, right? Because it takes the average of all the articles, and it is not necessary that each and every article basically will contribute into that calculation, right? I hope you are getting my point, and from this you can understand the calculation and all things related to the impact factor. So impact factor does not involve all the articles, right, into the in terms of the quality. This is true that the impact factor which basically analyzed by the Clarivate Analytics, only those journal which basically stands in a good way and publish high quality article regularly. But here the same question, that not all the article basically are getting equal citation. So that is the a point. So it is not necessary if you publish a article in high impact or good journal, good impact factor journal, In general, one thing I want to quote here, I am using actually frequently good journal and high journal. So how to define that good journal and high impact journal? So good journal are those journal which basically have impact factor 3 or greater than 3, but high impact journal are those which have the impact factor 10 or more than that. So you can see if you are publishing the article in a good journal, good impact factor journal, it does not means that all the article of that particular journal will get cited. So there is no criteria about to check the article's quality through this impact factor. Now the second and now the third one basically, and this is very important, which I think as you know that impact factor is calculated only of the regular articles, regular research articles, right? Not from the review articles or editorial notes and the news, book reviews. There are so many things which basically publish into the journals. Journals which have good impact factor, they also publish the review article as well as sometimes editorial notes. And some journals in general, in social sciences also, they publish the book review also. But they have the impact factor. So when we calculate the impact factor, it is not clear that which components actually are involved into that. The review article or the editorial notes or the book reviews, like that. So it is not very clear into the calculation of impact factor. So nowhere I have seen like this way, and I see the impact factor of the journal. So there is nothing is mentioned there that this impact factor is calculated only on the basis of the regular article. So as you know that the review article basically get more citation as compared to the regular articles. Basically, into the review article, more information are involved. Most of the time, researchers use the self citation, right? So when the self citation is involved, and the journal basically is getting the citation, right, from their own article of the author, then it becomes complex that it is involved into the calculation of the impact factor or not. But it is very clear into the JCR report. Right, so Clarivate Analytics basically define it that when the impact factor is involved with the self citation or not. So with the and without the self citation, the impact factor is available. But the question is here that does every journal basically provide this information on their homepage? They usually put the high impact factor basically in which the self citations are involved. When you remove the self citation into the impact factor, then the impact factor gets reduced by some amount, right? So in general that most of the publisher, most of the journal put the high impact factor. Right, they put the impact factor in which the self citations actually are involved. So this was the criteria, and that information is available, but journal basically don't provide this kind of information usually. Also, discipline matters. Sometimes you may have seen that into the medical studies and into the science like physics, computer sciences, physics, chemistry, math, all these subject into those and other subject like social sciences and arts subject, history, arts and creative arts like subject. So into education, so the journal basically which cover these kind of discipline and the journal which cover the medical and other popular sub disciplines, it so the impact factor actually varies, right? So there is no universal criteria for all the discipline to calculate the impact factor, right? So impact factor actually, if you see, is a relative number. So if you want to find out the impact factor of a specific discipline, like in case of physics, you want to see the impact factor, then the impact factor of a journal A, impact factor of a journal B, it will vary, right? So variation comes according to the citation. So citation here coming through the regular articles or review articles or through the book review or editorial notes, it basically is not clear, right? And second thing, you have seen that the discipline, so according to the discipline, basically impact factor vary. So if the if in any institute that basically provide the incentives or a kind of a promotion policy based on the impact factor variation, so like 1-2 segment, 2-3 segment, and there are many criteria for the promotion and for to get the job. So if the impact factor vary from 1-2 or 2-3 for all basically, so then there is a problem. In case of medical sciences, the very impact factor basically is much more. They frequently publish the article into the good journal, and in case of arts, if you see, there is a very few journal which basically have high impact factor, right? So it basically depends on the subject to subject, and when we approach to the promotion and to the taking for the research grants. So then all these things basically matters. If someone are not aware about to it and put the criteria or put the variation, a range of the impact factor to get the incentive in a university or in any institution, then it is wrong, because in an institution there are many discipline and all discipline impact factors are not same. So we have to check and review that thing also. This was basically related to the impact factor, and now I am calculating how basically the people calculate and this H index, and how H index basically taking the role where H impact factor impact factor basically was missing some important information. So it was basically invented by the George Harris in 2005, and he was basically related to the University of California, belongs to the physics. So in his calculation, he says that this is a numerical indicator, and it is based on the number of published article and the total number of citation to individual published article. Right, so in the calculation of H index, you can calculate the H index of a institution, you can calculate the H index of a researcher, or similarly you can calculate the H index of any journal or like that. Right, so you can its formula is easy. It based on the number of publication and number of citation corresponding to each article. So a very simple example you can see here. If a researcher, we say that in H index is 6, it means there are 6 articles which have at least 6 citations, right? There may be another article that might be he published 15 articles or 20 articles, but only 6 articles basically have at least 6 citation, right? We will see it by an example at the end, and but before that we will discuss some point related to the H index, that what H index is made for, and what H index has some limitations, right? Looks like into the impact factor. So this H index basically is useful for comparing researchers of similar career length. So if suppose there is a researchers or 3 researchers, so they are involved into the research or in a job since 2003, as you can say, or the period of their job is almost same, then we have to analyze the their research performance, right? So here we will just calculate the H index of the articles, and then we can say the H index is this one, right? Second thing is comparing researchers in a similar field, subject or department, and who publish in the same journals category, Obtaining a focused snapshot of a researcher's performance, it is based only on those things. And H-index is not useful for comparing researchers from different field disciplines or subject, right? Again, that same thing, same point that you had noticed into the impact factor. So impact factor basically varies from discipline to discipline. Here, H-index also. So the idea basically origin of the H-index is the drawbacks of the impact factor. So similarly, the H-index cannot say about to the different fields and disciplines of subjects when you compare it for an individual or for an institution. Assessing fields, department and subject where research output is typically books or conference proceedings, as they are not well represented by databases providing H indices. So sometimes nowadays basically trend is going on that most of the researcher publish the books and conference proceeding that are not involved into the citation purpose or like that. So in that case, basically, as you know that this criteria is again same as you have seen into the sources of the impact factor, where we says that impact factor should come out from the regular article. And here H-index basically covered that thing because in your article, in your publication, we just consider only the article, not the book chapter, not the conference proceeding. So obviously, if those are getting the citation, there is no role of that. So you cannot say that this is the H-index of your article. So H-index basically is related again to the article. So this point you have to understand. And here, basically on this particular website, if you will visit, all that information is available and I have also taken from there. The example which had mentioned here, you can see the researcher had published 8 articles, and out of 8 articles, articles basically have minimum 6 citations, right? You can see here. So you can put your article in this order according to the citation, higher citation, then lower citation, lower, like by this. So how many articles you had published? Suppose you had published 8 articles, and out of 8, 6 articles are getting 6 citations, right? You cannot consider here 7, because 7th number if you will consider, then minimum citation of all the 7 articles should be 7, right? So this is the criteria to calculate H index. So here you can see the H index of this researcher is 6. But here, what is the drawback you are observing here? The main point basically, this H index are not included rest of the articles which are getting basically less than 1 citation as compared to that criteria. So this thing is very important, and we have to think all about to the research matrices and these how basically these are used for different purpose. And nowadays basically people are not aware about all these things, so they are publishing into the high impact journal and high H index like that. So impact factor is associated actually with the Thomson-Reuter, and H index is associated with the Elsevier database, Scopus, right? One thing I want to say here, it is very important to understand that most of the time what happened. In the last video, I had mentioned about to the Google Scholar, that Google Scholar provide the idea about the citation. So citation, what the journals basically do, those who are not good journal, they calculate the impact factor with the help of the Google Scholar citations, right? So they know about to the citation of the last 2 years from the article information, and by which way they can basically calculate the impact factor. But here one is the important point. Impact factor basically is the copyrighted thing of the Thomson-Reuter, and that is the only agency, that is the only Clarivate Analytics is the only agency responsible for the defining the impact factor. If you are looking the impact factor of any journal, So check that whether that is given by the Thomson Reuters or not. If that is given by another agency, that is not valid, because this is the copyright, you can say, in a general way to understand it, right, of the Web of Science, that is given by the Clarivate Analytics. So this was the information related to the impact factor H index, and there were some facts basically by which the people are not aware. So we have to understand, and we have to focus only our the quality of the articles, right, instead of looking to here and there. Might be after 3 years and 4 years you can see a new parameter came to show the impact of the individual research, then what you will do? So we have to understand all these things, and we have to focus only the quality of the research article instead of these parameters which is given by the publishing agencies to analyze the research journals and the impact of the research of a specific area, right? So thank you for watching this video, and if you have any question you can ask, and anything related to this research and publication ethics, you can give me suggestion. Just comment into the comment box and let me know your point. If you feel that I had some mistake to explain at any point, or the idea was not clear, please let me know that where basically you are not able to get the exact idea related to that information, so I can make clear that. And it is also possible that if you know more about to the impact factor H index that I had missed here in this discussion, you please comment that information, so it will be useful for each and everyone. So thank you for watching this video, and to be with me all about to it.